people of Zion. Welcome to step 3 of 4 of my Investing in Cryptocurrency for Beginners series. This is where I talk all things wallets and I show you how to get your crypto the heck off an exchange and into a more secure software or hardware wallet. In this video, I'm gonna walk you guys step by step through how to set up the hardware wallet Ledger Nano X, which I imagine is pretty similar to setting up the Nano S. However, I just set up the Nano S to back up the Nano X because I wanted to be able to access the same crypto from two different devices, so I can't speak on it completely. And if you want to know how to use the Nano S as a backup to the Nano X, you can watch the video I did on that, as well as if you want to know how to transfer crypto from an exchange or other wallet into the Ledger wallets, you can watch those videos. But for now, let's just get to setting up our Ledger Nano X. Welcome back, the Oracle from the blockchain here, and happy to help guide you through the golden crypto country. All right, now remember, when it comes to discussing all these products and exchanges and wallets, and I'm not a rep, okay? I cannot give you all the ins and outs. I can just show you how I did it so that you can see how it can be done. And without further ado, let's get into it. To connect your Ledger Nano X, plug it in via the USB cable that it came with into your desktop or mobile device, whichever one you're using, and it'll also start charging the battery, so don't worry about the battery display. And then you'll be prompted to go to ledger.com/start on your secure browser, of course. I recommend Brave for extra security. And when you scroll down, you'll see step 1 of 4 and click download Ledger Live app to get the drop-down menu where you'll select what type of desktop or mobile device you're using. I selected Windows, ended up saving it to my desktop, clicked install, and then finish when it was done to launch the app. Once Ledger Live opened, I clicked get started and accepted the terms of use and privacy policy to enter Ledger app. Select your Ledger device, in this case the Nano X, and as this is the first time we're using it, click set up new Nano X. In the next couple pages, it'll give you info about your Nano X and the private key it holds for you to access your crypto that is stored on the blockchain, and you click the right arrow to move through the pages. And when you get to the page that says let's set up your Nano, you click let's do this. It'll let you know that you'll need about 30 minutes, a pen, and a zen-like meditation room to complete this. So once you have all three and are ready, click the button saying so. And this is where you move to your connected Ledger device and set up the 4-8 pin code that will be needed to access your wallet. You press the left or right buttons to navigate through the numbers and both buttons to select or validate that number before choosing the next number. Once done, re-input the numbers to confirm your pin code. Then you're gonna get your 24-word recovery phrase. So grab your recovery sheet and write them down in order. You are keeping this under wraps. No one can see this. You know, you're not putting it online anywhere. You're not, you know, taking a picture of it with your phone to help you. There's no digital trace. Let it be off grid. You know, store it on some paper. If nobody in your family reads the Bible, put it in there. You know, like, no one can see this, okay? When given the words, you're gonna press the right button to get to the next word and the left button to see or check the previous word. And then when you're done, it's going to ask you to confirm that you got it right by picking one of your words out of a selection of random words. And this is probably the longest step in this whole process. Once you're done and did good, it will say that your device is ready and head back to the Ledger Live app. Once you're back there, they'll not only remind you, like I just did, to hide your recovery phrase and not share it with anybody, but they'll let you know to never share your recovery phrase with Ledger Live. Don't put it into your computer, mobile device, anything but the actual device. And if it's finally gotten through your thick skull, say, okay, I'm done. You'll be given a 3-question quiz to clear up any misconceptions. And if you get the answers wrong, they'll just give you the right answer. So don't worry, stress, start looking up the answers online, whatever. It's not that deep. But you should actually read the questions and the answers because they are pretty crafty about making sure that you actually understand, you know, the whole thing. All right. So for the next final step, you're going to check your Nano to verify that it's genuine. So you're going to reconnect your device, which requires you entering your PIN into your device. So make sure you have your PIN nearby. And once you know, check it and make sure that it's not a fugazi, you know, it's not fake, you'll be good to go. You can start managing your crypto from your now set up Ledger Nano X. If it turns out that you were working with a fake this whole time, then I'm sorry. You just wasted your time, my time, you wasted everybody's time. Okay. If you want to know how to connect your Ledger Nano S to your X as a backup so you have two devices managing the same crypto, or if you want to know how to transfer crypto from other wallets or exchanges into your Ledger, or if you're like, I don't know if this Ledger's for me, I don't know, what is this treasure business I hear about? You can check out those videos. There's videos on all of that. But in the meantime, remember that this is the Oracle from the blockchain, reminding you to eat a cookie.